Hi, I'm Jordan, and this will be a really quick tutorial I can just show you, making Windows Vista style buttons. Vista! Hate Vista! But, I'm gonna show you anyway. Literally, it's gonna be so simple, you'd have to be mentally mindfucked not to be able to do this. So let's get started. File new, I've already got the dimensions in, 230 width by 80 high, which is a good workspace to work with. There we go, just gonna zoom in so you can see it. I'm gonna get a custom background color, so I'm just going on to my foreground color. I've already got it written down here as 2A, 2A, 2A. This gray was I picked off of a Vista scheme that my friend did. I'm gonna set the background color by using the fill bucket tool, and there we go. Next, I'm going to make a new layer and select the shape tool here, the rounded rectangle tool. Make sure the radius is 5 pixels. And also make sure that it's set to create a path. Click and drag. I'd say that about does it. If you wanted to move it, you can go into Marquee, right click and do free transform path like we did in the second tutorial. Center it a little bit. Apply it. Okay, now I'm going to select a black and fill the path. I do this by clicking on the pen tool, right clicking on the path and go to fill path. Obviously black is set as my foreground color, so I can click OK. Job's done. Go on the path and we can get rid of that path now, it's done. Go back to layers. Okay, now this is where some fun starts happening. I'm going to open up my layer styles window. Now I did this simply by double clicking on the layer that I want it to happen to. This is going to be where a lot of stuff happens, so I'm going to start by stroke. I'm only going to make it 1 pixel and it's going to be black. Now I'm going to go to my inner glow tab here. It's already set to screen, 75, that's all good, but I don't want it cream, I'm going to make it completely white. Let's see what size I'm going to have it. 5's way too big, I'm going to put it down to about 1. There we go. Yep, that looks all good. Next I'm going to go to outer glow. Pretty similar stuff, but I'm only going to set this to 50. There we go. Again, I want it to be white. So it's white. The size I'm gonna only put down to 3, and I'd say that's about good as well. Now gradient overlay I'm gonna go to next over here. I'm gonna need to custom this, so you do this by clicking on the actual gradient itself and it comes up with this. Now I'm looking for the kind of Vista green which I haven't eyedropped, so I'm just gonna go for a guess here. Double click on the color here at the bottom. And I'm gonna look here, I kinda want a greeny, a dark green. I'd say that's about right. Maybe a little darker. The code there's 003D44. I'm gonna click OK on that. And I wanna get a black as well, so I double click on the color strip here. Go to black. And there we go. I'm going to want another black just to add a little more darkness. I'm going to put it at 75%. You can see the location there? That's 75%, so it's 3/4 of the way up here. Click OK, and now we can start moving it around if need be. I'd say that's actually a good positioning. You can see how it's giving it a nice colour. But I might lighten that up, actually. So I'm going to change this to a little lighter. Here we are. The code's 005761. Okay it. Yeah, much better. You can see it's done there. Now I'm going to okay that. And that's all done there. I'm going to make a new layer. And what I'm going to do is, this is quite tricky, but it should be simple enough to pick up on. I'm going to select with the magic wand tool. Sorry, wrong layer. Go back on layer 1. The area around the bottom. Next I'm going to get the marquee tool and holding shift click and drag just on the bottom area. Now if I inverse it, control shift I, I've only just selected this top area up here. Now I can go into my layer 2, get a paintbrush out or a paint bucket and just fill it white. There you go. Deselect control D and I'm going to set the opacity to about 20, so nothing too vast. And that's that done. Now I can actually start putting some type on here. So I'm gonna have to use the font Myriad. I think that's the font that the Windows Vista has setup uses. I wouldn't know because I use XP, which is much better. Ah. There we go. I've just set the alignment to left justified. Just about center. I think I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. Let's see. For this, it should be about, I'd say 24 looks pretty good. See if you can just snap it into the center. Let's go to 100%, see what we've got. And there's your Vista button, which of course you can put anything on there. Anything you really want. You know, there's a lot of freedom with that, as it's, you can change it. And of course, if the text just happens to go outside of the box, you can always either make it smaller, like so, or if you made the canvas bigger, which I'll just show you. I'm going into image, canvas size, and I'm going to make it a bit longer up on the width. I'm going to put it to, 300, why not? Obviously the color isn't going to be there, so I'll just eyedrop the background and put that in. Selecting the background layer, just paintbrushing it in. There we go. And if I put my text back to what original size it was, which was 24, you can see it's too big. Oops. There you go. And what I'm going to do is just click on layer 1, the one with the button on, go to marquee, right click it, free transform, and do the same with the transparency as well, which it should just click, should click to the, it should snap to the other side. And there you go. There's a Windows Vista button which you can use. I don't know what you could use it for. Websites, fun gags like this, whatever. Anyway, if you liked it, leave me feedback, subscribe, rate 5 stars. They would be really nice things. But, you know, don't go hating just because I don't like Vista. You know. Anyway, bye. Vista sucks!